So in this video, we are going to study about multiple integrals. Now when you look at the word multiple, this clearly suggests we will have the double integration or we can have the triple integration. When I talk about the double integration, this means that I will have two variables. Now double integration of f of x, y dx dy. Let my two variables be x and y. Now this function can be anything like xy, x squared and anything, y squared. You can take any example. But my main motto is to clear about the dependent and the independent case in this slide. Now what is that? As you can see, we have the limits of x here and then we have the limits of y here. When I say that I have limits of x, it can be constant or it can have some variable in terms of y. Similarly, if I talk about y, it can have some constant like let's say 0 to 2 or it can have the variable in terms of x. So here comes the dependent and independent case. Suppose my example is x is equal to 0 to 2, y is equal to 1 to root x, f of x comma y dx dy. In this case, x has the constant limits 0 and 2, but y has the variable term, that is root x, the term x, the variable x it has. So this clearly suggests it is the dependent case. So the important point is one limit will have the variable and the other limit is constant in dependent case. But when we talk about the independent case, both are constant. X is also constant, y is also constant, f of x comma y dx dy. Very important point to note down. Let's see some example to clear our concepts. So dependent case. Let's say the example is integral of x is equal to 0 to 1, y is equal to 0 to x, x dx dy. Now our function is x. Okay, so how to solve this? That's the main case. One variable is x, other variable is y. So which one to solve first? Either the integration with respect to x or the integration with respect to y. Now here comes the concept. This is our concept. If y limit has the x term, I am repeating again, if y limit has the x term, solve y first. This means you have to integrate the y limit, whatever you have, the function which will have the y as the variable, then dy. Here x will be treated as constant. X is constant. So do that case here. So there is no y term, only you have dy, then you have y limits. So you can say that integral of y is equal to 0 to x dy. This would be solved first and x dx would be treated as constants. Now solve this integration. It's a pretty simple integration, that integral of dy is y, upper limit is x, lower limit is 0. So x minus 0 is x. Then you can see now our integration is x is equal to 0 to 1 x into x dx. So x square integration is what? X cube by 3. Upper limit is 1, lower limit is 0. So 1 cube by 3 minus 0 cube by 3, the answer is 1 by 3. So this is the basic idea. Y has the x term. So y limit has the x term, solve y first. And this is the concept. If you are taking the y limits, y would be treated as the variable, x would be treated as constant, and you are integrating with dy. I hope you got the example. Let's take one more example. Now the example is y is equal to 0 to 1. X is equal to 1 to y square. So x has the variable term, that is y. Okay, dx dy. So the function f of x comma y is 1 here. Now how to solve this? Again, the concept is if x has the variable term, so if x has the y term, solve the x integral first. So take this x integral, x is equal to 1 to y square dx. You have to solve this first, as you can look here. Now integral of dx is what? X, but the upper limit is y square, lower limit is 1. So upper limit minus lower limit, you will get y square minus 1 dy. Integrate this, simple. Y cube by 3 minus y, upper limit is 1, lower limit is 0. And the answer is 1 by 3 minus 1, which comes out to be minus 2 by 3. A simple logic, but logic remains same if the limit, like if x has the y term, solve the x first. If y has the x term, solve the y limits first. Okay, let's move forward. Now in the dependent case, there is no such confusion at all. As you can see, x is also constant, y is also constant. So clearly you can separate x and separate y. They are not dependent on each other, so the answer won't be affected. So integral of x dx and x limits are 0 to 1 Integral of y dy and y limits are 0 to 2. Solve this. X square by 2, 1, 0, upper limit minus lower limit. Here it would be same y square by 2. Upper limit is 2, lower limit is 0. After solving, you will get half into 4 by 2, which comes out to be 1. As you can see how simple it was when I talked about independent variable case. And it's always going to be simple. Gate questions are asked on this topic. So please take a special care what is dependent and what is independent case. Okay, let's move forward. Never mismatch the concepts. Now what does this mean? Never mismatch the concept. Suppose I have the question as integral of x is equal to root y to 2 and y is equal to 4 to x square. Okay, now this is interesting. As you can see, x limits has the variable y and y has the variable x. So which one to solve first? So the answer for this, it is not possible. Such integrals are not possible. You cannot solve this kind of integration. One is always a constant and other can have the variable. Then it is a dependent case. Both can be constant. Then it is independent case. There is not such example as you can see here. It cannot exist. So always one variable has the constant limit. Now this means x is constant or y is constant, but on the other hand the second variable should have the dependent limit in the dependent case. In the independent case, both the limits of x and y are constant. I always say these concepts because when I deal with the big question, the hard question, the small basics is important. Okay, let's move forward. Now what if limits are not given? Up till now, as you can see, the limits were x is equal to 0 to 2 and let's say y is equal to 0 to root x. The limits were given and thus you can solve the question. But what if I say the limits are not given? Then how to solve this kind of question? So the solution is the next video. So be there with this course. I will make sure you get the solution soon.
So friends, agar aapko meri video pasand aa rahi ho, then do like this video, share with your friends and subscribe to my YouTube channel. So milte hain agli video mein. Till then, take care. This is Shrenik Jain. Peace out.